A great way to drive traffic to your blog is to have visitors pin something called long pins to Pinterest. There are different programs that you can use to create a long pin, such as Photoshop, PicMonkey, or Canva. But what if you don't have access to those programs? The answer is that you can actually use PowerPoint to create a long pin. What I'd like to do in this little video is to show you how to create a long pin using PowerPoint. I'm going to open PowerPoint. And the version of PowerPoint that I'm using is PowerPoint 2011 for the Mac. I'm actually doing this on my MacBook Air. I want to select the white template, and this brings up a title page with two boxes that I want to get rid of. I can get rid of the boxes in one of two ways. I can select the box and press Delete. Alternatively, I can select Layout on the Home tab and Blank for a blank slide. Now that I've got the blank slide, what I want to do is I want to resize it to the perfect dimensions for a long pin. I want to select the Themes tab, which is next to the Home tab, and I want to select Page Setup, Slide Size. I want to select Page Setup, and I want to do three things here. One, I want to change the slides sized for to custom. I want to change the orientation from landscape to portrait, and I want to change the dimensions to a width of 2.45 inches, and a height of 9 inches. Select OK, and so now I've got a template that's the perfect dimensions for my long pin. In building the long pin, what I want to do is I want to add two photographs and some text. I've already dealt with the photographs in terms of cropping them to the size that I want, and the size is 6 inches wide, 9 inches high, or in dealing in pixels, 1800 pixels wide, 2700 pixels high. I want to insert the first photo, go up to Insert, Photo, Picture from File, and I've saved the photos on my desktop, so I'm going to select Desktop, and I'm going to select my first photo. I'm going to move it up to the top of my pin, and then I'm going to add the second photo. Insert, Photo, Picture from File, Desktop, and my second photo. And I'm going to move that down to the bottom. Now the reason that I chose the dimensions for my pictures 6 inches wide, 9 inches high is twofold. One, I wanted the resolution of the pictures to be sufficient such that they would be clear when I actually publish my pin. And the second thing that I wanted was some white space so that I could add some text. To add the text, I'm going to go to the Home tab, select Text Box, and I'm going to draw a text box in the white space. At this point, I don't have to worry about the position because I'm going to take care of the position once I have the text looking the way that I want. But I am going to select the center for justification. I'm going to type delicious on the first line, beef on the second line, and stew on the third, delicious beef stew. Now, in looking at that, I really don't care for the font style, so I'd like to change that. I'm going to highlight the text. I'm going to go up to the drop-down box for my font styles, and let's see. Let me choose Apple Chancery. That looks pretty nice, and actually, I like the way that looks. But you could select any font that you wanted that was available. The current point size is 18, and I'd like for it to be a little bit bigger, so let me try 20. That's a little bit better, but still small. Let me try 24. Yeah, I like that size. So I like the way that it looks, but the position's not good, so let me move it up and over and try to center it. There, that looks pretty good. So at this point I could stop and say I've got my long pin, but what if I wanted the white space to be a different color to coordinate a little bit better with the pictures? I can change the background style by going back to Themes and over on the right-hand side choosing Background. Now right now the background is the default blue, but I'd like something of a different color, so I'm going to select Format Background. I'm going to change the color from Automatic to, I think I'll choose More Colors. And I'm going to use Spectrum here. I'm going to select the eyedropper, and I'm going to move it over to my picture and select a color that I think would coordinate pretty well. It's kind of hard to see, but let me select this green. So right now the color is green. I'm going to say OK. And you can see now that the color has changed to green. And I'm going to say Apply. Now that looks pretty good, but I'd rather my text be white as opposed to the black. So I'm going to go back to the Home tab. I'm going to select the text, Delicious Beef Stew, and I'm going to change the color to white. So now I've got a long pin, and I could leave it like that, or I could add a little bit more to it. Actually, let me show you how to add some border. Let me show you how to add some lines. So on the Home tab, I'm still there. I want to select Shapes, Lines and Connectors, and just the straight line. And I'm going to draw a line. At this point, I'm not concerned about the position because I can change that in a minute. But I don't like the fact that it's a blue line. I don't like the shadow, and I think that it should be a little bit wider. So next to the Home tab now, there's a tab for Format. I want to format the line. I want to change the color to white. Go back to line. I want to change the weight. Let's see, let me try 4.5 points. Actually, I think I'm just going to leave it at that. But before I leave, I want to change the effects to get rid of the shadow. So shadow, no shadow. So that looks pretty good. Let me move it up a little bit to the position that I want it to occupy. And let me copy this line to put the same line at the bottom. So I want to go to Edit, Copy, Edit, Paste. And I want to move the second line down to the bottom so that it's roughly in a similar position to the top line. Yeah, that looks pretty good. So now that I've got my long pin the way that I want it to look, the last thing that I want to do before actually uploading it is I want to save it. I want to go to File, and I want to save it as a picture. Save as Picture. Let's call it Long Pin. Let me save it to my desktop so it's easier for me to show you. And I want the format to be JPEG. So I press Save. And when you save a PowerPoint presentation as a photograph, then what PowerPoint does is it creates a folder with a separate file for each of the slides. And I've only got one, but let me show you what I'm talking about. Let me get out of PowerPoint and go to my desktop. Here is the folder with my long pin. Let me open that. Let me select the slide just to show you. And so here is my long pin. Before uploading it, the last thing that you might want to do is you might want to change the name. So if you right click, then I'm going to just call this Beef Stew. So again, there you've got your long pin ready to upload to Pinterest.